So we've got the Lord's Supper, we've got baptism, and there's a third practice in the church that does parallel both of these, but we don't often think of it in the same type of spiritual terms, and that is our financial giving. He says, but as you excel in everything, in faith, in speech, in knowledge, in all earnestness, and in our love for you, see that you excel in this act of grace also. I say this not as a command, but to prove by the earnestness of others that your love also is genuine. For you know the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, that though he was rich, yet for your sake he became poor, so that you, by his poverty, may become rich. This is a fascinating statement Paul's making. He said, listen, he's saying to this one church over here that is a little bit more wealthy, a little bit more well off. Look at the example of the poor church. Look at their earnestness. By their giving, they show that they have truly been saved. And Paul here gives us the reason for giving. He says, for you know that the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, that though he was rich, yet for your sake he became poor, so that you, by his poverty, might become rich. So notice what he gives as the example of why we give. Because when we give, we look back. We look back at what Jesus did for us, the fact that he stepped out of eternity into humanity and lived a sinless life here on the cross, gave up all of that came with being God, and then he was nailed to the cross for sins he did not commit, sacrificed himself, and that's why we give. Because Jesus was generous, we are generous. You don't give to God because he pays you back somehow. We know that the reward is future. Now, in what sense is it future? What is this reward? Well, we don't know for sure. Scripture never says, but I think there's a key in this text. What does he say? He talks about sowing. He talks about reaping. And he says, somewhere here, and increase the harvest of your righteousness. Well, that's a term that pops up a lot in Scripture, this harvest idea, the sowing seeds, this harvesting. I think the reward is people who will join us in eternity. Our giving impacts people for the gospel.